this island voted in overwhelming numbers to see beyond the scars of violence and mistrust and to choose to wage peace. Over the years, other breakthroughs and agreements have followed. That's extraordinary, because for years, few conflicts in the world seemed more intractable than the one here in Northern Ireland. So that when peace was achieved here, it gave the entire world hope. The world rejoiced in your achievement, especially in America. Pubs from Chicago to Boston were scenes of revelry. Folks celebrating the hard work of Hume and Trimble and Adams and Paisley and so many others. In America, you helped us transcend our differences, because if there's one thing on which Democrats and Republicans in America wholeheartedly agree, it's that we strongly support a peaceful and prosperous Northern Ireland. But, as all of you know, all too well, for all the strides that you've made, there's still much work to do. There's still people who haven't reaped the rewards of peace. There are those who aren't convinced that the effort is worth it. There are still wounds that haven't healed and communities where tensions and mistrust hangs in the air. There are walls that still stand. There are still many miles to go. It requires compromise. And it requires absorbing some pain from your own side. So I applaud them for taking responsibility for law enforcement and for justice, and I commend their effort to building a united community. Important next steps along your transformational journey. Because issues like segregated schools and housing, lack of jobs and opportunity, symbols of history that are a source of pride for some and pain for others, these are not tangential to peace, they are essential to it. If towns remain divided, if Catholics have their schools and buildings and Protestants have theirs, if we can't see ourselves in one another, if fear or resentment are allowed to harden, that encourages